associated with this atom is assumed to be if all the bonds associated with this atom is assumed to be electrovalent or ionic. Ionic bond you have got?
Yes sir.
Ionic bond, covalent bond. Okay, so write down first. All the bonds associated with it is assumed to be electrovalent or ionic. See, there are two, three types of bond we have which the atoms forms to form a molecule. The one is covalent bond, where we have a sharing of electron. The electron gets shared between the two atoms. Okay? Ionic bond, what happens? The more electronegative element will have the electron pair towards its side. Right? Suppose if I take an example of NaCl. If you see the electronic configuration of sodium and chlorine, sodium has one electron in its outermost shell. What is the atomic number of sodium? 11, right? So we write down, you know, electronic number what? 2, 8 and 1. Right? For sodium. What about chlorine?
17.
So in the last shell it has 7 electrons. 17, right? 17 into 2, 8 and
7.
So you see this configuration. To gain octet, octet, you know what is octet?
Yes, sir.
Outermost shell should have 8 electrons. So to gain this atom, a sodium octet, it requires 8 electrons in the outermost shell. So it is very difficult to accept 7 electrons, and it is easier to lose this one electron so that it will have 8 electrons in the outermost shell. So it has tendency to lose electron, but it has tendency to accept electron, right? 7 electron plus 1 get 8, right? So what happens, the electron of sodium, suppose this dot is the electron of sodium we have, and the 7 electrons of chlorine is this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Okay? So what happens? This Na will donate its electron to this chlorine, right? And we have the positive charge on it. Correct? Since chlorine accepts one electron from the other atom, so it has one extra electron, so it has one negative charge. Now we have this positive and negative charge. So we'll have attraction and positive and negative charge. This attraction we call it as electrostatic attraction. The attraction is similar to the attraction we have seen between the two opposite charges, right? So it is a charged species, positive charged species. It is also negative charged species. So we'll have attraction between these two, and that's why Na plus and Cl minus are bonded together. This kind of bond we call it as what? Ionic bond or electrovalent bond due to electrostatic force of attraction. Right? So this is ionic bond, and that's what the, you know, the definition of oxidation number is. If all the atoms, all the bonds between the two atoms is assumed to be what? Electrostatic. Right? When it is electrostatic, then the charge on the species is said to be what? The oxidation number on that particular atom. Like in case of NaCl, the oxidation number of sodium is what? Plus 1. For chlorine is what?
Minus 1.
Similarly, if you take MgCl2, right? So charge on chlorine is what? Minus, and here it is?
Plus 2.
So oxidation number of magnesium is plus 2, chlorine is minus 1. Right? So this is what oxidation number is. We assume all the bonds to be electrostatic. Apart from this, I have discussed covalent bond, electrovalent bond, that is ionic, and one more we have, we call it as what? Coordinate bond.
Coordinate
bond. We'll discuss that also. Again, all these things we'll discuss in chemical bonding chapter. Okay, I'm giving you a brief idea so that you can understand the things, right? Write down next line. This example also, write down these two examples. Na plus and Cl minus and MgCl. Okay, now how to assign oxidation number? We have two, three rules into this. First, we will write down first to assign oxidation number. These rules actually you have to memorize. Okay? To assign oxidation number. First case you write down, in case of ionic compound. In case of ionic compound, write down. In this case, the charge on an atom is taken as the oxidation number. charge on an atom is taken as oxidation number. Example is this only, NaCl, MgCl2, you can write it. +2, -1, +1, -1. Okay, NaCl, MgCl2. Second case, write down, in case of covalent bond, in case of covalent bond, write down, in covalent bond, the plus one charge is given to less electronegative element. In case of covalent bond, the plus one charge is given to less electronegative element, and minus one charge is given to more electronegative element.
So basically, plus one to electropositive, minus one to
electronegative. Yes, relatively, which one is electropositive? Okay. For example, you see HCl. In HCl, chlorine is 4 electronegative element, right? So we'll have Cl minus and H plus. Right? This is the oxidation number of chlorine and H plus. Now you tell me the oxidation number of carbon in all these molecules. See this oxidation number of carbon in all these molecules. The first one is CH4, the second one is CH3Cl, third one is CH2Cl2, CHCl3 and CCl4. Oxidation number of carbon you have to find out. You know this method to assume X and hydrogen is always plus one, right? Carbon is slightly more electronegative than hydrogen, so it is X, it is plus one. So what will write X plus 4 into plus 1 is equals to what? 0. Why it is 0? Because CH4 is neutral, there is no charge in CH4.
Yeah.
Right? So X value is what? Minus 4, so oxidation number of carbon is what? Minus 4 in this molecule. Similarly, here also we'll assume X is carbon, plus 1 is hydrogen, and minus 1 is chlorine. So what we'll write? X plus 3 into
1
plus 1, minus 1 is equals to
0.
So what we'll get here? X equals to
minus 2.
Minus 2 is the oxidation number of
carbon. Yes, sir.
Now again, this is minus 1, plus 1, and X. X value is what?
0.
0 in this case? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
For this one, X plus 1 plus 3 into minus 1 is equals to 0. X equals to?
Yeah.
Plus 2. Plus 2, and here it is X equals to
plus 4.
So whatever the charge on the species we have, net charge, I'll write on the right hand side. Okay? Can you find out the oxidation number of carbon in CO2 or sulfur in SO4 2-? Oxidation number of carbon in CO2 or sulfur in SO4 2-, sulfate ion?
+4 equal to -2.
Okay. Write this one, what we write? Sulfur is X. 4 into minus 2 is equals to?
Minus 2.
Minus 2 because the charge on serpentine is what?
Minus 2. Minus 2.
That's why you will write here minus 2. Okay.
In carbon,
is this molecule is CO2, right? There is no charge on this molecule, it is neutral. That's why it is CO2, yeah. Understood? Now the value of x is what we have?
6.
Plus. Now one more thing we try to understand here. With this structure also we can find it out. And that is a better method actually we have. For CH4 the structure will be what? Carbon is bonded with
4
hydrogen. And number of bond only you should know between the two atoms. Right? Now what we do, since we have to consider the bond is electrovalent, or since it is a what? Covalent bond we have. So we will get plus 1 to less electronegative, minus 1 to more electronegative. Right? So carbon and hydrogen, carbon is slightly more electronegative. The difference is not that much. But if you have to compare the electronegativity of carbon and hydrogen, carbon is slightly more electronegative. So for this particular bond, the carbon will have what? Minus 1 charge on it and plus 1 charge on this hydrogen. Yes or no? Similarly for this one,
again
minus 1 plus 1, again minus 1 plus 1, again minus 1 plus 1. So what is the total charge of carbon?
Minus 4.
This total value is what? Minus 4. That is what we are getting. Okay? Similarly, CH3Cl if you have, CH, H, H and Cl. Now the chlorine is more electronegative, right? So it is minus 1 and it is
plus
1. Okay, minus 1, plus 1 and minus 1, plus 1 and minus 1, plus 1 and minus 1. So we have 3 negative charge, 1 positive charge, net is what?
Negative 2.
Minus 2. Minus 2, that is what you are getting. Right? So this actually gives you the real picture. Here this value is the average value. You will understand this later on. I'll show you some examples, you will understand. This x value or this method gives you the average charge on that particular atom. Since we have only one carbon atom, so average is nothing but same. But we have, and when we have more than one atom present, then it may be different. We'll discuss that also, we'll see. For CO2, you see this one, we'll discuss CO2 and SO2 minus. The structure is C double bond O and C double bond O. It is a linear molecule. That's why it is like this linear molecule, right? All these structure, shape, geometry, all these things we'll discuss in chemical bonding.
What's linear?
Linear is the molecule is linear. Like you see, if the carbon is attached with one hydrogen this way, one oxygen this way, so it's a linear molecule. The bond angle should be 180. This is not linear. It is tetrahedral geometry. Tetrahedral means what? The carbon you have here, suppose, and one hydrogen is this way, one hydrogen is this way, another hydrogen is this way. So we have a triangle like this, right? At the vertex of this triangle, we have three hydrogen present, and on the top here we have carbon. And all these three hydrogen are joined with this carbon. And with this carbon, there is one more hydrogen present here. So if you imagine this shape, we have a triangle like this with three hydrogen in the vertex, one carbon here and one hydrogen here. This geometry is what? This geometry is tetrahedral geometry. Right? So all these things, what will be the geometry, what will be the shape, all these things we'll discuss in chemical bonding. And that geometry and shape is not required here. It's not required in draft reaction. Okay? Geometry and shape we'll discuss in chemical bonding. We have a method for this, we'll understand that. You don't worry about it. So carbon, if you write like this also, it won't make any difference. Right? We have to find out what charge on carbon atom. But since this is linear, so better to write this way, not to this. That's what the thing is. It's not linear, not the bond angle is not
180.
Linear molecule should be straight. It is straight, bond angle should be 180. Right? So you see the carbon oxygen is more electronegative again. So what is the charge on this oxygen?
Minus 2.
We'll give minus 2. Why? Because we have two bonds here. Right? One bond so minus 1, two bonds so minus 2. Here also it is minus 2. So it is minus 2, so this one is?
Plus
2. Plus 2, this one is?
Plus
2. Total is what?
Plus
4. That is what we are getting. Okay. Sulfate ion, you see, we have SO4. The structure of sulfate ion is this, and you have to memorize this structure. It is not that difficult. But again, like I said, structure and everything we'll discuss in chemical bonding. After that chapter, you'll understand all these things. Okay? Again, the sulfur atom is sp3 hybridized, geometric tetrahedral. That's why I have drawn the same structure like this. Okay? Now, the sulfur has two negative charge on it, right? Two minus charge we have here. Whenever oxygen is bonded with one single bond, what I said? Oxygen is bonded with one single bond, it will have one negative charge on it. Right? So since we have two negative charge here, it means it gives us the information that out of four oxygen, two are bonded with single bond with the sulfur. That's why the structure is this. You cannot write down this. When you make this bond single bond, which you have to put one negative charge here, which is not possible because there is not negative, the three negative charge is not there. So all these ideas you will have when you do the chemical bonding chapter. Okay? So for now you just write it down, sulfate ion is this. Right? Now you see S double bond O, because of this double bond, what is the charge on the sulfur? On the sulfur?
Because minus
plus 2, right? Oxygen is more electronegative.
Yeah.
Here, because of this double bond, the charge on sulfur is what?
Plus 2.
Plus 2. Because of this?
Plus 2.
Again plus 2. This is?
Minus. Plus 1.
Plus 1. And this is?
Plus 1.
Plus 1. Total charge is what?
6.
Plus 6. That's what we're doing.
So.
Understood this? Right? So this structure method is more important since you have started now. So you may have this difficulty that how to memorize all this structure and write down the structure of different molecules. But you have to understand this. When I am telling you this structure are very common and very simple, after 2-3 months you will be very familiar with all this structure. These are not difficult, right? And you can understand this structure very easily after the chapter chemical bonding, right? So like this we find out the oxidation number, but this is just the example we have done. These are the examples we have done. We have a set of rules to find out the oxidation number. That also we will see. But before that, one last case we'll discuss here. The third case write down in case of coordinate bond. Write down. In case of coordinate bond. What is coordinate bond we'll discuss? The first you write down. First case in this you write down. In this there are two possibilities. First possibility you write down. When it is directed from less electronegative element. When it is directed from less electronegative element to more electronegative element. This is not that much important, just to write it down. Okay? Less electronegative to more electronegative element. In this you write down. In this case, minus 2 charge is given to more electronegative atom and minus 2 charge is given to more electronegative atom and plus 2 charge is given to less electronegative. Less electronegative atom. For example, you see NO3 minus, here we have one coordinate bond present. Right? NO3 minus will have one coordinate bond here. And this information I am giving you. Right? You should keep in mind. Now the structure of NO3 minus is this. Since we have one negative charge, it means one oxygen bond should be single bond, right? And double bond O. One single bond O minus, and this is the coordinate bond we have. Coordinate bond we represent like this, an arrow from the electron donor to the electron acceptor. This is the structure of this. Coordinate bond we'll discuss, first to write down this. Now because of this you see, this double bond, so we'll have plus 2 charge here.
Plus 1.
Plus 1. And what is the rule for this? Oxygen is more electronegative than nitrogen. First three most electronegative element you must remember, fluorine is most electronegative, then oxygen and then nitrogen. These three very important. Electronegativity order. Fluorine is the most electronegative atom in periodic table. Then we have oxygen and then we have nitrogen, right? So you see the coordinate bond is directed from less electronegative element to more electronegative element. What is the rule we have? What charge you should give to more electronegative element? Minus?
Minus.
So according to the rule, we have to give here minus 2 charge to oxygen and plus 2 charge to nitrogen. What is the total charge here? Plus 5. So oxidation number of nitrogen here is plus 5. Okay. Similarly, if you calculate by X method also, if nitrogen is X, oxygen is minus 2.
Minus 2.
So we'll write X plus minus 2 into 3 is equals to
minus 1.
Minus 1. Because the charge is minus 1. Yes. So X equals to what? Plus. Okay, X equals to plus 5. Okay, now you see, if you have this, what is coordinate bond first of all? Suppose the molecule is this, I have taken H2O molecule, water, OH2. Water molecule, oxygen has two lone pair on it. Again, this information you should have. Oxygen has two lone pair. What is lone pair? You know?
Not bond, not even.
Or let it be oxygen, this one. NH3. You know NH3?
Ammonia,
right? Nitrogen is bonded with 3 hydrogen and it has one lone pair on it. This is lone pair.
Electron right? Not involved.
If you don't like this, let it be like this. Okay, one lone pair. Lone pair means what?
Not
pair of electron which is not involved in bonding. It is available on the atom. Right? So when this nitrogen has one lone pair on it, so it has tendency to donate the lone pair of electron, right? Suppose any species H plus is moving around this nitrogen, right, this molecule. It is electron deficient, yes or no? Hydrogen has one electron, one positive charge on hydrogen means what? It has donated its electron, that's why it has one positive charge. So it is electron deficient and it has tendency to accept one pair of electron. Correct? So this nitrogen donates its pair of electron to this H plus, right? And forms a bond like this. We write it as like this NH3, and this is a coordinate bond directed towards the electron pair acceptor, which is hydrogen in this case. And since nitrogen has donated a lone pair of electron, so we'll have one positive charge on nitrogen. Right? So the definition of coordinate bond is what? It is the bond which forms between the two atoms where the bond pair of electron originates from the same atom. Right? Here you see in case of NaCl, one electron of sodium and one electron of chlorine was there. But here the both electron is of nitrogen. Hydrogen has no electron present. So when the both electron originates from the same atom, the bond form is known as coordinate bond. We'll discuss this thing in detail in chemical bonding. This arrow is directed towards the electron pair acceptor. Donor to acceptor. Donor to acceptor. Right? This is what the charge here. All these things, if you are not getting it, let it be. Don't worry. Okay? What you have to keep in mind is the bond is directed from low to more electronegative element, then we will give minus 2 to plus 2 charge and the oxidation state to plus 2. Yes,
directed from
less.
The ammonia is donating 2 electrons, so it should be plus 2 pair of electrons.
Plus 2. NH4 plus 2 electrons, plus 2.
And it's an ammonia is donating 2 electrons. So the charge at N should be 2.
No, actually you see, actually what happens, this it donated its lone pair of electron. But nitrogen is still bonded with hydrogen, no? One electron it is completely donated to hydrogen. Actually here we have 2 electrons. But this electron is completely with this hydrogen. One electron is still associated with this hydrogen. So actually what happens, it donates this electron. No. Actually what happens, it donates this electron, but half of the one electron is associated with nitrogen and half of it associated with hydrogen. Similarly for other electrons also. That's why total one positive charge will get. It means we have two electrons we have donated to hydrogen. So half of each of these electrons is associated with the same atom because they are in that bond. Right? That's why we give only one positive charge. Understood?
How are we supposed to know all this?
Huh?
How are we supposed to know all
this? I'm telling you this.
No, anyway.
This is only parallel. This is parallel action. Chemistry is very difficult to study on alone. Right. That's why I'm telling you. See, again I am telling you, if you are not getting this, let it be. We'll discuss this in detail, how this coordinate bond and all form. What you have to understand, what is the oxidation number? Okay? How do you know? That's what my job is. I have to let you know. Okay? Where, what happens? That's what I am supposed to do. Okay? Few things you can study from the book, but not everything. Okay, and in one book, all the things are not given. Right, so one more case in this, we write down a second case. Write down, when it is directed from less electronegative element to more electronegative element. Less electronegative element to more electronegative element. In this case, the contribution will be zero. There is no contribution of coordinate bond where it is directed from more to less electronegative. For example, you have C double bond O, one lone pair on carbon and two lone pair on oxygen. Right? So in this CO bond, what happens? Oxygen donates its lone pair to this carbon. This is the coordinate bond difference. Right? So contribution of this bond is zero. We have minus 2 because of this double bond on oxygen, plus 2 on carbon. That is it.
Okay. So this is the structure of carbon monoxide.
CO, yeah. Carbon monoxide. Draw this structure.
Yes. And directed from
more to less.
More electronegative to
less. Understood? And one more thing, this I know you have some confusion in this particular coordinate bond, right? This is not very common, you will not get this usually.
In the main JEE.
But since it is there, it's there in this level, you should know this. So if you are not getting this, we'll let it be. Once we'll discuss, we'll do this again. Right? So don't worry about this. Now these are the few things we have to keep in mind. But like I said, there are a few general rules to find out the oxidation number. So write down the rules for oxidation number. Rules for oxidation. For few elements it is fixed.
Fluorine.
No, for few elements it is fixed. The oxidation number is fixed. I tell you, first point to write down.
Direct from more electronegative, less electronegative, no.
No contribution. First point.
This time for one.
What is other elements? What are
group one elements?
What? You wrote it, no?
Yeah.
Okay. First point to write down. What is alkali element?
Group 1 element.
Elements of group 1 except hydrogen.
Hydrogen is not an element.
That's it.
Write down. First point. In case of alkali metal.
Rules for oxidation.
In case of alkali metal. The oxidation number.
In case of what?
Alkali metals. Alkali metal, group 1. The oxidation number is always plus 1.
Yeah. Even other way, hydrogen is in that group.
It depends. It's not always plus
1.
Okay. That's why we have N plus, K plus always. We don't write N2 plus. Right? Second point to write down, in case of alkaline earth metal, that is group 2 elements, the oxidation number is what?
Plus 2.
Always plus 2. In case of alkaline earth metal, the oxidation number is always plus 2. What point? The oxidation number of fluorine is always minus 1. the oxidation number of fluorine is always minus 1. Oxidation number of elements, fourth point, the oxidation number of elements in their free state or uncombined state is always 0. Free state, uncombined state is always 0. Right? So when you write Na, Mg, O2, C4, N2, always oxidation number will be 0. Right? Free state, uncombined state, oxidation number will be 0. Next point, the oxidation number of oxygen. The oxidation number of oxygen is mostly minus 2.
Oh yeah.
It's mostly minus 2. Except
dioxide.
2-3 exceptions we have here. Generally it is always minus 2. It's mostly minus 2 except the first one.
Peroxide.
In case of peroxide. Right? In case of peroxide. In case of peroxide, the oxidation number of oxygen is minus 1. Right? For example, we have H2O2, hydrogen peroxide. Okay, oxidation number of oxygen will put here minus 1, not minus 2. Right? Next, what we have? Na2O. It is also peroxide. So what of peroxide we have? We have to keep in mind.
How Na2O is
peroxide? It's a peroxide.
Valence electron.
Yeah. Na like O will come there. Like valency of oxygen is 2. So basically it will be there.
What?
Like how is Na2O peroxide? Like Na2O2, then oxidation number.
Na2O2 won't form. Oxygen is Na is monomeric.
Exactly.
And oxygen is monomeric.
Oxygen is divalent.
Yeah. Is monomeric.
But then oxidation number here will be minus 2 only.
I think it should be Na2O2.
Or Na.
Minus 1 into minus 2 plus 1.
N2O2.
Okay. Examples are this. Okay, peroxide oxidation number is minus 1. We'll do the examples again. Second point you write down. In case of superoxide,
it's minus 1.
Yeah, in case of superoxide. Superoxide is
O2.
O2 minus. Superoxide is O2 minus. Oxidation number is minus half. Example is KO2.
Or H2O.
H2O is not formed.
Alkaline metal is alkaline.
Hydrogen is not an alkaline metal.
But forms peroxide.
H2O2 it forms. Superoxide does not. KO2. Next one, write down ozonides. In case of ozonides, what happens? O3 minus.
So
its oxidation number is?
3.
Minus 1 by 3. Oxidation number is? Minus 1 by 3. Ozonides.
Only one, right? Ozonide.
Huh?
Like, so what? KO3.
RbO3.
Rubidium.
Example, last one we have, in case of, write down, in case of oxygen difluoride, OF2. In case of oxygen difluoride, it is plus 2.
Because fluorine will never change.
Minus 1. Oxidation number of oxygen is plus 2. These 4 examples or 4 exceptions we have, otherwise we always have minus 2 oxidation number on
oxygen.
Oxygen difluoride. Oxygen like product. Oxidized product we also call this.
Chlorine. How is it? Most of the thing chlorine is more in the first place for other properties.
That's why this is one of the methods we use for nomenclature of the molecule also. For naming. Okay. Next, write down next one. The oxidation number of hydrogen is mostly plus 1.
Except
the oxidation number of hydrogen is mostly plus 1. Except in the case of metal hydride.
Where metal will take plus.
Oxidation number of
hydrogen is mostly plus 1. Except in the case of metal hydrides. What are metal hydrides?
NaH.
Metal hydrides, write down, are the hydrides of group 1 and group 2 element. Metal hydrides are the hydrides of group 1 and group 2 elements. For example, we have NaH, KH, BH2, MgH2, etc. All these are metal hydrides. The oxidation number of hydrogen is
minus 1.
Minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, everywhere.
Oh.
Otherwise, it is plus 1.
Plus 1.
You see, alkali metals always have plus 1 oxidation number. Hydrogen minus 1, some sodium
plus 1.
Potassium plus 1, plus 2.
Plus 2 into N minus 1 into 2.
Metal hydrides? Minus 1. Only in case of metal hydrides. Hydrogen oxidation number is minus 1 always in the case of metal hydrides. Otherwise it is plus 1. Next slide on. The oxidation number of sulfur in sulfides is minus 2.
Sulfide H2 minus
2. Yeah, H2S, Na2S. The oxidation number of sulfur in sulfides is minus 2. Sulfides is minus 2 and the last is minus 2 in sulfides H2S, Na2S, hydrogen sulfide, sodium sulfide. Okay, last point to write down. The sum of the oxidation number of all the elements of all the atoms present in a compound, the sum of the oxidation number of all the atoms present in a compound is equals to the charge on the compound. Is equals to the charge on the compound or I.
Sir, then Na plus oxidation number is 1, right?
Okay. So these are the rules you have to keep in mind. Okay, these rules 6-7 rules that I have given you, it is important, more important. Okay, so this you must remember. Next class we will do some examples on this. Okay, examples and then method of balancing of redox reaction and electron method. Okay, and whatever we are doing here in the class, that only the syllabus will be that only for redox reaction. Okay, for the test. Okay, tell me what more I have done the assignment and the last class. Sir, whole concept.
I didn't get it.
How many of you have done?
Assignment.
What assignment? I have given you the assignment before that holiday only.
Sir, we
did. It's
not. You are
not there. Who are not there?
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. What?
Tell me the name. Who are not there? Name?
Mehak.
Mehak was not there. Next?
Shabi.
Was not there. Next? Alberta. Was not there. Next? I shared the assignment with you on your WhatsApp number. Yes? Don't lie.
SWAIRT.
Sorry, your name is not there in the class.
Yeah,
not there.
I just joined.
Okay, sorry. Anyone? How many of you have done except these four?
Sir, I did some, I didn't get some.
Huh?
I did some, I didn't get some.
Show me your notes.
No, there is no more.
Not done. Huh? Okay. You? What's your name?
Amala.
Right. Only Amala has done. You're there in the group, what's up?
I'm opened the drawer with the keys. Keys are left there only.
Solution is given in the